KTO PFNA Gamma Nail System Operation Demo. Step 1. Position. Put patient on orthopedic traction bed in a supine position to monitor operation process with perspective machine. Step 2. Reductions of fractures. Satisfaction of the fracture reduction in torque to 10 degrees to 15 degrees or greater angle, or reduct the injured limb to 10 degrees to 15 degrees and fix it in the traction bed. Step 3. The length and diameter of the main nail chosen. Put developing template in front of femur. Put proximal part on insertion site and distal part on the expected position. Read out the length of the nail directly. Predict the diameter with records of developing template. Step 4. Surgical approach and insertion site. From the apex of greater trochanter to proximity, cut it horizontally for 5 to 6 cm in order to enter accurately. The site is the junction of the trochanter major apexes front third and rear two-thirds. Normal position is located in the apex of greater trochanter. Step 5. Open medullary canal and remin. With the proper power, open medullary canal with countersink awl along the insertion site and then insert ball guide pin along the tail of countersink awl until the ball reaches desired depth. Remove other devices, reserve ball guide pin, install the obturator, set ball guide pin on softer reamer to remin. Softer reamer can start from 5-9 mm with gradually increasing. Install the softer reamer shutter after the reaming beginning. Should use 5-60 mm softer reamer to do proximal reaming. When reaming has been done, remove the softer reamer and reserve the ball guide pin. Step 6. Nail insertion. Fix prepared KTO PFNA pin on holder with connecting screw rod. It should be tightened with connection screw wrench. Set ball guide pin onto and insert it into with the swinging holder slightly. If needing to knock in, you should install pin inserter into the card slot of holder and tighten it with open end wrench. Connect with pin leg and knock pin in slightly with slide hammer. Finally, remove the insert device and ball guide pin. Step 7. Proximal lock-in. Install the buttress rod on the holder and fix it. Insert the blade nail combination sleeve into the holes of buttress rod until soft tissue skin. Just below, we are cut about 1.0 cm incision. And then to the cortical bone directly, locating with the targeting arm. Remove phi 3.2 position pin and drill phi 3.2 guide pin into. Monitor the placement status with perspective machine. Measure the actual length of the phi 3.2 guide pin, which is the bone with guide pin depth gauge. Remove depth gauge and phi 3.2 sleeve. Drill proximal cortical bone hollow drill and then proximal limited hollow drill into. Instocatio PFANA, nail counterclockwise with Nokian, locking screwdriver of the blade nail, which combined with Phi 3.2 guide pin inside to insert. After the above, knock the Nokian locking screwdriver with hammer slightly until the limited depth. Monitor the placement status with perspective machine. Rotate the Nokian locking screwdriver clockwise after position is ensured. The occlusion of the gap means KTO PFNI nail has been locked. Remove the proximal non-implanted device to retain holder and connection screw rod. Step 8. Distal locking. Fix the distal static rod 180-220 on the holder. Insert distal locking nail combined sleeve into the most distal locking nail holes, just below where cut about 0.5 cm incision, and then to the cortical bone directly. Drill Phi 4.0 pin into firstly, and then change to drill hole with Phi 4.0 drill bit after the pin drilled into a small concave point in the surface of bone. Adjust the distance between ball spike and distal locking nail drift sleeve to 1.0 cm with axial wrench when the Phi 4.0 drill bit through the first layer of bone and reach the contralateral canal wall. Next, continue to drill through the contralateral bone. Keep the distal locking nail drill sleeve close to the bone cortex. Insert guide depth gauge to measure the diameter of bone. Then screw Phi 4.5 locking screw into it with 3.5 screwdriver. Attention, it should not be excessively tightened. Finally, monitor the placement status with perspective machine. Repeat the above steps to complete the second operation that locking nail placed. Step 9. End caps placement. Remove all non-placement devices and deduct the injured femur. Install suitable end caps with T-end caps wrench. Screw it along the tail of nail in counterclockwise firstly, and then clockwise. Do not over-tighten. KTO PFNA Gamma Nails Removal. Insert Phi 3.2 pin into the central hose of KTO PFNA blade nail. Set blade nail leg on the long Phi 3.2 pin. Rotate to connect and fix KTO PFNA blade nail counterclockwise, and then take out it. Remove distal locking nail with 3.5 screwdriver. Retain the locking tail. Remove end caps with T-end caps wrench and install pin leg. Take out the final locking nail with 3.5 screwdriver. Finally, remove the pin with slide hammer. Distal Locking Scheme 2, Dynamic Locking Installation Operation Demo. Fix the distal dynamic rod 180-240 on the holder. Insert digital locking nail combined sleeve into the most distal locking nail hose. just below where cut about 0.5 cm incision, and then to the cortical bone directly. Drill 5 4.0 pin into firstly, and then change the drill hole with 5 4.0 drill bit after the pin drilled into a small concave point in the surface of bone. Adjust the distance between ball spike and distal locking nail drill sleeve to 1.0 cm with axial wrench. When the 5 4.0 drill bit through the first layer of bone and reach the contralateral canal wall with the purpose to protect the contralateral soft tissue. Next, continue to drill through the contralateral bone. Keep the distal locking nail drill sleeve close to the bone cortex. Insert guide depth gauge to measure the diameter of bone. Then screw 5 4.5 locking screw into it with 3.5 screwdriver. Attention! It should not be excessively tightened. Finally, monitor the placement status with prospective machine. The distal locking is over. Remaining operations are same with static locking scheme.